Facing Waves is brought to you in part by Eddyline Kayaks, legendary designs since 1971. Welcome back to Facing Waves. This week, we're sea kayaking in San Juan Islands with the Eddyline Kayaks crew. The San Juan Islands offer ideal conditions for first-time paddlers, with much of the water being sheltered from wind. But the islands are also known for large tidal exchanges, which create powerful rapids for the more adventurous boaters to explore.
So we're here in Bowman Bay, and pretty neat area, definitely affected by tidal flow. Right now we have a pretty strong moon, and so we're getting a pretty strong ebb and flood. And right now water's coming back in. One of the neat things about that is the seaside is always changing, revealing new creatures and new treasures to look at. And also one of the neat things about tidal changes is right around the corner in Deception Pass, that water either rushes in or rushes out through a very small passageway. And that creates a lot of fun currents for us to play in. Essentially, it becomes a large river. And in sea kayaks, we can play in these sea kayaks as if they were little whitewater kayaks. We get whirlpools and boils. Some of them just kind of pop up and grab your boat and take you on a merry-go-round. And to the beginner, that might be a little scary, but for us, we find it fun and it challenges our skills and makes us better paddlers. I'm gonna lose my mind, cause it's never fine, cause you're always so quick to play torn apart. The entire bay on an ebb tide goes all the way out through Deception Pass, and it just funnels through this narrow little gorge. And so that creates some really fast currents that move through there. And on a flood tide, you got the entire Juan de Fuca Strait emptying into that same bay, again, flowing into the backside of Whidbey Island. And you can get currents that go up to 7 knots, and that's really fast, definitely faster than I can paddle against. You can get some really big whirlpools that form, but it's also actually really easy to get into because you can sit there at a slack tide and kind of build it up, and then when it gets too big, you can bail out. Well, some of the touring kayaks out there are very designed to go straight and fast. And so when we get those long touring boats in confused waters, currents that pull and push away from you, they can grab the ends of your boats and spin you around in a hurry. You do need the speed of a long boat to make it up through those currents, so that's important. And yet at the same time, the length really requires us to be on our game and know where the direction of our boat is going and the direction of the ends of our boats. One little misdirection or a whirlpool develops underneath you, you might find yourself upside down, and it's good to either have a kayak roll or friends there to rescue you.
So we spent some time playing in the boils and the whirlpools of Deception Pass in the Room of Doom there. And on my last run through, I got in and I thought I was doing pretty well, but then one of those eddies and currents just caught me over. I was upside down and I was kind of thinking to myself, okay, I'll just like let it smooth out a little bit and then I'll roll up. And then I was like, okay, I feel a little bit smoother. Go to roll and all of a sudden I just feel the boat pitch over. And it's like, oh, okay, I'll sit here a little more. But eventually I kind of ran out of breath, so I tried to get up, and unfortunately it rocked me around a little bit more. So I just had to ride it out a little bit more. Unfortunately, couldn't ride it out long enough.
Well, we were in the Deception Pass. It was cranking. This guy's a pro, and even he found time to swim, and I certainly swam early on. So we're gonna have to drink our beer out of a booty. That'll make you get your roll next time.
Hi, I'm Alex Stoffel. I'm here with Ethan Ebersold. We're both with Eddyline Kayaks, and we want to take a minute today to talk about the boats we chose for this San Juan trip.
I chose the Fathom here with a slightly firmer stern for great tracking efficiency, a little bit of a higher foredeck for the medium to large size paddler. Ethan chose the Raven with a little bit more of a rocker profile for a playful nature and a medium fit. Both boats, long touring kayaks that can get us where we need with speed. They also have perimeter deck lines and bungees for storage. There's also three bulkheads for dry compartments and safety flotation. Whichever boat you choose, they're definitely great boats for the San Juans.